Hello everyone, my name is G and I am one of the leaders of City Light Soul. I hope you are enjoying the book of Ecclesiastes as much as I am, and today I am going to share what I have learned from Ecclesiastes 11. So first we are going to read from Ecclesiastes 11, so if you can grab your Bibles and follow along as I read. The Word of the Lord. Ship your gain across the sea. After many days you may receive a return. Invest in 7 ventures, yes, in 8. You do not know what disaster may come upon the land. If clouds are full of water, they pour rain on the earth. Whether a tree falls to the south or to the north, in the place where it falls, there it will lie. Whoever watches the wind will not plant. Whoever looks at the clouds will not reap. As you do not know the path of the wind or how the body is formed in a mother's womb, so you cannot understand the work of God, the maker of all things. Sow your seed in the morning, and at evening let your hands not be idle, for you do not know which will succeed, whether this or that, or whether both will do equally well. Light is sweet, and it pleases the eyes to see the sun. However many years anyone may live, let them enjoy them all. But let them remember the days of darkness, for there will be many. Everything to come is meaningless. You who are young, be happy while you are young, and let your heart give you joy in the days of your youth. Follow the ways of your heart and whatever your eyes see, but know that for all these things God will bring you into judgment. So then, banish anxiety from your heart and cast off the troubles of your body, for youth and vigor are meaningless. And all God's people said, Amen. As I was studying chapter 11, it brought me to divide this chapter into different segments of verses, and each segment has a specific theme. First, we are going to discuss verses 1 to 2, and the theme for this is giving. Giving generously without expecting in return, and it is about giving with all our hearts. When we give, we tend to choose who we give to and how much we give. However, we always forget that our Heavenly Father has given us everything, His one and only Son, Jesus Christ, to each and every one of us equally. Recalling Matthew chapter 6 verses 3 to 4, but when you give to the needy, do not let your left hand know what your right hand is doing, so that your giving may be in secret. Then your Father who sees what is done in secret will reward you. I have been struggling with giving for most of my time. It is because I take pride in my ability to save, and at the same time, I have difficulty trusting God that He will actually provide for all of my needs or even the desires of my heart. And even though saving money is really important, when it prevents me, you, us from actually giving when God calls us to give, that will pose a problem. So I was reminded of Hebrews chapter 13 verse 5 that says, keep your lives free from the love of money and be content with what you have, because God has said, never will I leave you, never will I forsake you. Moving on to segment number 2, verses 3 to 4. The title of the segment is Cause and Effect. Everything has a cause and effect. When the clouds are full of water, there will be rain. When a tree falls, which direction it will be, it will lie there. When we end up only pondering on what we should do and how we should do it instead of actually proceeding with it, we will never be able to sow or reap. We get so absorbed with ourselves when God calls us to do something, or He puts something in our hearts, instead of proceeding immediately with obedience. We tend to think about how we should do it, how we should proceed with it, and make plans instead of immediately obeying and trusting that God will lead us step by step. So this made me conclude that being trapped in our own minds is also a trap towards disobedience, and this will lead us to neither plant nor reap. The next segment is verse 5, and the theme is Only God Knows. There is an addition to basic knowledge and technology every single day, and science is evolving every second. However, there are many things still that we will never be able to understand or comprehend during our days here on earth. Only God knows, for He has made all things. As it is said in Genesis chapter 1 verse 1, in the beginning, God. Following God is not following Him blindly. How can it be when He is the maker of all things? He is the beginning and the end. He knows what was, what is, and what will be. The next segment is chapter 6, and the theme is faithfulness. This teaches us to be faithful in both our tasks in the morning and in the evening, whatever we do when we are young or when we are old. Let not our efforts to do our best become faint when we are older, but continue to do your best. Stay faithful for the Lord, for we do not know whether one or the other or everything we did was used for His glory. As it is said in Lamentations chapter 3, verses 22 to 23, because of the Lord's great love, you are not consumed, for His compassions never fail. They are new every morning. Great is your faithfulness. As a procrastinator, I get fired up in the beginning, and as the deadline approaches, I either have not finished it or I don't even like give half of my best. And some procrastinators I know, they don't do anything or just think about it in the beginning, and they end up giving their best and really pushing themselves as the deadline's approaching. But we are called to do our best no matter what the season or time, for we do not know the true result of our actions. So as I have learned through this chapter and a few months ago, my mentor has always told me, be faithful as He is faithful. The next segment is from verses 7 to 8 on things eternal. So bright days are beautiful and it gives joy to our hearts and soul. The darkness, not so much. But as long as you live, enjoy both the days of light and darkness. Remember them both because they are part of who we are. Great joy and praise to God in both the days of light and darkness. More so in the darkness, as once more, everything to come is meaningless. You must look towards the things of eternal, as it is said in Colossians chapter 3 verse 1, since then you have been raised with Christ, set your hearts on things above, where Christ is, seated at the right hand of God. And the last segment is from verse 9 to 10. In Nehemiah chapter 8 verse 10, Nehemiah said, go and enjoy choice food and sweet drinks, and send some to those who have nothing prepared. This day is holy to our Lord. Do not grieve, for the joy of the Lord is your strength. Whether in youth or old, we must have the joy of the Lord in our hearts. More so in our days of youth, when everything is enjoyable and carefree, when all we want to do is follow our heart's desires and we want to pursue what we see as attractive. But like verse 9 says, but know that for all these things God will bring you into judgment. Honestly, I thought this was a little bit passive aggressive, like, yeah, enjoy your youth, but remember, God will still judge you. Youth in our bodies will not last. It is for us to focus on the Lord and banish anxiety from your heart and cast off the troubles of your body. God has created us, for He loves us, and we were also created to enjoy Him forever. A quote by Aidan Wilson Tozer says, God is trying to call us back to that for which He created us, to worship Him and enjoy Him forever. I'll lead us into prayer, and let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, praise be to You, O God of heaven and earth, who knows all things and is not limited to these. Blessed be the Lord who deserves all glory and praise, who created all being with His breath. Father, please forgive us when we chase after things of the world and replace them and choose them instead of You. Forgive us for trusting in ourselves and our own discernment instead of obeying You and trusting that You are going to lead us and guide us. Father, thank You for calling us always back to You and for giving us Your Word, the living Word that reminds us of things eternal, the things that we should set our hearts and minds on. Father, please continue to speak to us. Call us to be closer to You. Pull us to a deeper faith as we explore more of Your Word in the coming days. Open our spiritual ears, minds, and hearts, and give us a desire to continue studying Your Word. You have told us in Matthew chapter 4, verse 4, man shall not live on bread alone, but on every word that comes from the mouth of God. This is our prayer, and we love You, we praise You, we give You all the glory. In Jesus' name, amen. Thank you for joining me in the study of Ecclesiastes chapter 11. I hope you enjoyed it as much as I did, and I hope to see you soon.